Good morning all. I hope you have watched both the videos of the topic library classes. In this video, I have compiled the questions for this topic from year 2012 to 2019. I hope this will be helpful for you while preparing for the examinations. These questions are there in the PDF format also. The link is given in the description box. You can check, download and prepare for the exams. As in previous video, I told you that from this topic, around 2 to 4 marks questions comes in section A, and the functions of this topic can be used in programs in section B. So today I am taking all the questions from year 2012 to 2019 of section A. Let's begin with the question of 2012. State the method that converts a string to a primitive float data type. So here the conversion is there from string to primitive data type. In previous video only we did all these conversions from string to different primitive data types. You can refer to that video. Let's check the answer. From string to float. So here wrapper class function float dot value of string, this is used to convert string into float. The next question of this is determines if the specified character is an uppercase character or not. Here this function is character of wrapper class character. Character dot is uppercase. This function is used to check whether the given character is uppercase or not. So these two functions, like this only you will write the answer. You don't have to write in sentence format or any other method, paragraph format. Just to the point, write the answer, that is sufficient for the exam. Now we move on to year 2013. The first question is name any two wrapper classes. Last video I told you many wrapper classes for each primitive data type. So you have to mention any two here. I can write integer and character. These two wrapper classes for data type int and char. Apart from this, you have double, float and more are there. Any two you have to mention. And I told you that the first letter of the wrapper class starts with capital letter. Don't forget that. This is must. Otherwise, if you will write float all in small letters, that will become data type, not the wrapper class. Okay. Next, we move on to the question. What is the data type that the following library function returns? Is white space. Last video mein hi maine aapko bataya tha. इस किसी भी फंक्शन में लगा होगा तो उसका आंसर हमेशा बुलियन होगा. बुलियन डेटा टाइप ही होगा. इस मींस इट इज इन अ क्वेश्चन फॉर्म. सो आंसर विल बी आइदर ट्रू और फॉल्स. सो द रिटर्न टाइप ऑफ दिस फंक्शन इज वाइट स्पेस. कैर सी एच इज बुलियन. इट विल चेक इफ दिस गिवन कैरेक्टर इज ब्लैंक. इट विल रिटर्न ट्रू. अदरवाइज इट विल रिटर्न false. So the return type will be boolean. Now the question can be, here it is asked data type. If the question is asked what values it will return, then you have to write either true or false. But since in the question data type is asked, so we will write the data type of the values, true and false, that is boolean. Now the questions of year 2014. The first question is, what is meant by a package? A package is a collection of classes that contains built-in functions. This definition and more definitions are there in the PDF of the previous video. Please refer to that for more details. Then second question is, what will be the output? 1001 is stored as string. Then x integer dot value of. This function is used to convert string into primitive value and it is stored in int type x. Similarly, this is stored in double in why, then you have to print these three statements are there. So output is always generated using print statements. So the first print statement says x equals to. So your output will be x equals to plus x. The value x contains the integer form of this. So the answer is 1001. The next print statement says y equals to plus y, double format. So it is 1001. Zeros will be there. Then the next statement is the king said backslash double quotes. So if before double quotes backslash is given, that means it is a skip sequence, and here backslash will not be printed and only double quotes will be printed. So here the output will be the king said double quotes begin at the beginning and exclamation is there, then again backslash double quotes, so double quotes will be printed to me. So three print statements using println, so we'll have the output on three different lines. Now the question of year 2015, which says name the wrapper classes of char type and boolean type. I am solving it here so that you know how to write the answer. Presentation also matters. So please be a little more careful when you are attempting the question. Wrapper class kaun si hai, char or boolean? So here you can write data type kaun kaun si classes ke liye likhna hai aapko. Unke naam is heading mein likhenge aur iski corresponding wrapper class ke naam likhoge yahan par. So you can put the headings like this. Char and boolean. For these two data types, I want to give the wrapper class. So char ka wrapper class hota hai character with the capital C, and boolean ka wrapper class hota hai boolean with capital B. So if you see from year 2012 to 2019, in each year around 2 to 4 marks questions are there from this topic. So very scoring, very easy, prepare well. Now this is the question for year 2016. Write the return type of the following library function. Is letter or digit of char? Just now I told you, किसी भी function में अगर is है तो बिना कुछ सोचे समझे उसका return type boolean लिख दोगे. So boolean is the return type. Simple one word answer and you will get full marks in these type of questions. Now we move on to year 2018. Write a difference between the functions is uppercase and to uppercase. See the question, write a difference is there. So only one difference is sufficient. Here I am writing two for you. You can write only one, or if you want you can write both the differences. Is uppercase, it checks whether the given character which you are passing as argument is in uppercase, that is capital or not, and to uppercase converts the given character or string into uppercase. The second difference is uppercase returns boolean value and to uppercase returns char or string type value. Now in this year one more question was there. Name the package that contains wrapper class. The first video of library classes we did this. I hope you remember. I'm telling you the answer. Which package is there? java.lang package contains the wrapper classes. Next we move on to year 2019. Again here two questions are there. First is give the output. 20 and 19 are stored as string in p and q. integer.parseInt and integer.value of these two functions I told you are used to convert string to int data type. So here a will contain 20 and b will contain 19 as integers. Print statement is there to print the value of a, so the output will be 20 plus within double quotes nothing is there, but since a string entry is there in between, so A and B, these two will not be added. That means 20 and 19, it will not result in 39. It will print first the value of 20, then nothing is there but string entry is there plus B. So 20 and 19, this will be the output of this print statement. The next question says, state the data type and the value of RES after the following code gets executed. Char CH equals to 9. RES equals to character dot is digit. मैंने आपको बताया था किसी भी फंक्शन में is होगा तो return type उसका क्या होगा? Yes, return type will be boolean. Boolean again here return data type लिख रहे हैं तो B small में ही लिखोगे, अगर capital B लिख दोगे तो वो आपका wrapper class बन जाएगा. RES की value क्या होगी? Character dot is digit of CS check करेगा, ये अगर digit है तो return true करेगा, otherwise false करेगा. CH में कौन सा character है? 9, and 9 is a digit, so it will return true. So this will be the answer. ऐसे ही answer लिखोगे, कोई paragraph में नहीं लिखोगे, just to the point you will write the answers. Hope you have understood how to write the answers of the given question, and this topic is also very important as it contains 2 to 4 marks direct questions in section A. So please prepare them. PDF link is there in the description box. We'll be doing more quizzes, more questions on different topics. So if you haven't subscribed the channel yet, please do so. And press the bell icon so that you get all the notifications and no important topic is missed by you. Keep practicing, keep studying. God bless you.